إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله تبارك وتعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. All thanks and praise is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We thank Him, we praise Him, we seek His help and we seek His forgiveness, and we seek refuge in Allah from the evil within our own selves and from our bad deeds. Whosoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, no one can lead astray. And whosoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lead astray, no one can guide. And I bear witness that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his final messenger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in the meanings of which, O you who believe, obey Allah the way He ought to be obeyed, and do not die except as Muslims. O mankind, be dutiful to your Lord, the one that created you from one soul, and from it He created its mate, and from them both He created many men and women. So fear Allah through whom you demand your mutual rights. Allah indeed is all watcher over you. O you who believe, obey Allah and always speak the truth. He will guide you to do righteous good deeds and He would forgive you your sins. And whosoever obeys Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has indeed achieved the great success. The best speech is the speech of Allah, the Quran. The best guidance is the guidance of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the worst of the matters are the new invented matters in the religion. And every new invented matter in the religion, bid'ah, is an astray, and every astray is in the hellfire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَهُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ خِلْفَةً لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يَذَّكَّرَ أَوْ أَرَادَ شُكُورًا. Which means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that made the night and the days successor to one another, alternate between the nights and the days, for those who want to take heed and for those who are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The fact that we see these signs from Allah, the universal signs from Allah, we see it on a daily basis. We see it with every breath we take. Life that we live in, the day and the night, the earth, the skies above us, the air that we breathe, this entire universe that we live in, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created it for a reason, and that is for people to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran and in the sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, in many, many verses, commanding us not to be forgetful, to be always reminded, to have our hearts, to humble ourselves, to always witness the creation of Allah, the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and not to be heedless of it. Now we are witnessing daytime. How many of us with their hearts are witnessing this? Not just the fact that we are during the day and then the night comes and the night was before that. Alternate between the day and the night. It's all by the power of Allah, by the decree of Allah. Ayat, signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the hearts to humble itself, to witness the power of Allah, to witness the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this creation. That He is the all-powerful, the almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most wise, the most merciful. Al-Khaliq, the creator of the heavens and the earth, and so on and so forth. And then as a result of that, a person would follow the commands of Allah. Because the day and the night are not created just for people to sleep and wake up and eat and drink and seek provisions and that's the end of it. This is abath. This is wasteful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we negate any deficiency when it comes to the names and attributes of Allah. He is Al-Hakim subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most wise. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala is able to create this life that we live in, all just nights or all just days, and it's mentioned in the Quran. قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمُ اللَّيْلَ سَرْمَدًا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ مَنْ إِلَهٌ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ يَأْتِيكُمْ بِضِيَاءٍ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed for you that you have the night, it's all nights till the day of Al-Qiyamah. Who ilah? Who is the one that is worthy of worship other than Allah that will give you light? No one, it's only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمُ النَّهَارَ سَرْمَدًا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ مَنْ إِلَهٌ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ يَأْتِيكُمْ بِلَيْلٍ تَسْكُنُونَ فِيهِ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would make the diya, the light, to be there for the rest of your life, and there's no night, تَسْكُنُونَ فِيهِ, to have the sukoon, the tranquility, the rest, who other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring this for you? No one but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Human beings, they ought to witness this with their hearts, to humble themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And every single physical sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, it has its effect on the purpose of our life, which is the ubudiyya to Allah. We're created for no reason but to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. And the perfect way of life, the religion of Islam, makes this connection, makes the Muslim is interacting with this universe in the most perfect way. Because the commands from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to observe the acts of worship fits perfectly with the creation of Allah, because it's all from Allah. أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرُ. To Allah belong al-khalq, the creation, and to Allah belong the amr, the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there is never contradiction. And that's why there is ubudiyya to Allah, there is worship and servitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the night, and there is worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the day. And there is worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when a person is healthy versus someone that is sick. Someone wealthy, someone is poor. Someone is young, someone is old. Ubudiyya to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. My salah, my nusuk, my sacrifice, my life and my death is all to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has no partners subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the Lord of the Alameen. And by this I have been commanded. This is to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and to the ummah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and to be the best and to be the first among those who submit themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you as a man, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a man. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you as a woman, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a woman, and so on and so forth. The ilm, the knowledge of this, we already have it. اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. On that day, in حجة الوداع, the day of Arafah, as mentioned before, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completed the religion and perfected His favor upon this ummah and pleased for them to have the religion of Al-Islam as their religion. So we ought to learn how to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with these matters, and the verse talks about two things. وهو الذي جعل الليل والنهار خلفة. خلفة, successors, alternate, one follows the other in such an amazing thing that human beings, they just watch and see. But the believers, they are different. They witness the power of Allah, they humble themselves to Allah. And as the verse says, لمن أراد أن يذكر أو أراد شكورا. For those who would wish to يذكر, to take heed, to take a reminder, to take a lesson, to make remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because we are in ghafla otherwise, and therefore all human beings are in ghafla, forgetfulness, the day after the night, the life passing one day after the other, one year after the other, get them closer to the last and final moments on the face of earth without paying attention what's the purpose of their life. And if they do, they keep on forgetting, and that's why the ibadat, the acts of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brings us back to be always conscious of this. So that's why there is ubudiyya during the day, salawatul khams, three of it, al-dhuhr wal-asr and al-fajr, fajr and dhuhr and asr during the day, maghrib and isha during the night. Ibadah during the night, you cannot make it during the day. Inna salata kanat ala al-mu'minina kitaban mawquta. The salah is upon the believers in a prescribed times. It is not permissible to pray fajr at 10 o'clock in the morning, even if his fajr time starts at 3:30. Who's the one that created al-fajr wal-isha wal-maghrib and all of these times? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who's the one that alternate between the day and the night in the summer time versus the winter time? رب المشرقين ورب المغربين. Why does it change? By the power of Allah. Part of that is for people to be tested. We don't choose what time to pray fajr. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that commanded us to pray fajr. Fajr time starts at 3:30. سمعنا وأطعنا. We listen and we obey. This is how the day starts. And you see how people, when they set the alarms the entire year at 7 o'clock in the morning. 7 o'clock in the morning, this is after sunrise. Already the day started during the summertime versus the winter time. Ubudiyya to Allah. With regards to the obligations, with regards to the optional acts of worship, Salatul Layl, Qiyamul Layl, during the night, as the Prophet ﷺ used to observe, and as it's mentioned in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, some of the early generations of Al-Islam, they used to witness this by even giving charity during the day and during the night. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised those who worship Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they are yunfiquna ana al-layl, the hours of the day and the hours of the night. So they would give something, acts of worship during the night and acts of worship during the day, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of the heavens and the earth. لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يَذَّكَّرْ. For those to have the proper reminders that we live our life according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees this life. He sees this life subhanahu wa ta'ala as what? This is a life where we're supposed to observe the amal, the actions. This is darul amal versus darul jaza, the recompense in the day of judgment. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he talked about this dunya versus the hereafter, he said, اِقْتَرَبَ لِلنَّاسِ حِسَابُهُمْ وَهُمْ فِي غَفْلَةٍ مُعْرِضُونَ. The hisab, the reckoning of the people, is coming closer and nearer while they are in forgetfulness, playful, playing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّهُمْ يَرَوْنَهُ بَعِيدًا وَنَرَاهُ قَرِيبًا. We see it as very near. They see it, meaning the day of judgment, as far. And we see it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala see the day of judgment as being very near. And we are creation of Allah. And we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So we have to see it as very near. And when you see something very near, something like the day of judgment, then we have to prepare ourselves for it. It is not permissible to be forgetful about these major matters. And therefore to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accordingly. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ الْعَظِيمَ لِي. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم عباد الله الله سبحانه وتعالى says وهو الذي جعل الليل والنهار خلفة لمن أراد أن يذكر أو أراد شكورا. It is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that made the night and the day alternate successes one after the other. For those who want to take heed and take lesson and make remembrance of Allah, and for those who want to be grateful to Allah. So this is the time to be occupied with being grateful to Allah. Being grateful to Allah that we still witness the day after the night and the night after the day. It's a great favor from Allah to be alive, to fulfill the purpose of our life, to increase our good deeds, to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to make our ibadah, to worship the creator of the heavens and the earth, to observe the limits in our life, halal and haram. This is the beautiful way of life, that a person is a abd, is a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His life is about sami'na wa ata'na, following the way of the Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. And this is the test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the entire humanity, for those who accept versus those who do not accept. And also the word khilfa, it succeed one another. It's also one of the meanings of it, that if you missed something during the night that can be made up, then make it up during the day. And the Prophet ﷺ said that with even the optional acts of worship. So you can imagine then when it comes to the obligations. مَنْ نَامَ عَنْ حِزْبِ عَنْ وِرْدِ. Whoever overslept and he did not recite his portion of the Qur'an that he recites during the night, with the night prayer or reciting the Qur'an. فَقَرَأَهُ. Then he recited it from after Fajr till Dhuhr. It will be recorded for the person as if he observed it in its prescribed time. So the time during the day between Fajr and Dhuhr is the time to make up whatever is missed during the night if a person misses it. But the norm of the Muslim that he is consistent. الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَاتِهِمْ دَائِمُونَ. They're consistent when it comes to their salah, their ibadah. If a person accidentally overslept and he woke up at 10 o'clock in the morning and he missed Fajr, then he make up the salah as if he prayed it on time. مَنْ نَامَ عَنْ صَلَاتٍ أَوْ نَسِيَهَا فَصَلَاتُ حِينَ يَذْكُرُهَا. Whoever overslept or forget a salah, then his salah whenever he wakes up is its prescribed time for him. But that happens every so long. Not that a person intentionally would do such a thing. So observing these changes of the day and the night to make up even whatever is missed. If the morning adhkar is missed after Fajr, still do it. If the evening adhkar is missed, still do it. Having awrad, having on a daily basis a portion of the Quran, even if it's one verse, three verses, to reflect, to understand, to act upon the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, to observe the ayat, the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why with the time of the salah, this is something that a believer observes, the change of the day and the night. If it's summertime and people, they have vacations or the students are off from school, to observe the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the ability then to worship Him. Not times to be forgetful, not times to be playful and that's it. Yes, observe what Allah permitted, but where is the determination to observe the salah on time, to observe the recitation of the Quran, memorization of the Quran, the good deeds, to help the poor, to enjoin the good and forbid the evil, to learn the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before a person is busy and with matters of responsibilities and so on. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most wise. And when we read the Quran, when we humble ourselves to the sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam, then we follow what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to be upon. And at-tawbah, repentance. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَبْسُطُ يَدَهُ. As the Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam said, بِاللَّيْلِ لِيَتُوبَ مُسِيءُ النَّهَارِ وَيَبْسُطُ يَدَهُ بِالنَّهَارِ لِيَتُوبَ مُسِيءَ اللَّيْلِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extend His hands during the night for the one that committed sins during the day to repent. And He extend His hand for forgiveness during the day for those who committed the sin during the night. So constant repentance to Allah. The day is repentance. The night is also a person is seeking forgiveness from Allah. And if this is the one thing that a person is upon with the time keeps on going, this is the act of ubudiyyah to Allah. At-tawheed wal-istighfar. To be upon at-tawheed with all its obligations. To worship none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and to worship the rights of Allah and the rights of the human beings that Allah obligated upon us. To raise our children according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. To be kind to others and so on. And with that is to observe with that the tawbah. To constantly repent to Allah. We make tawbah after every salah. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness that we did not fulfill our salah in the most perfect way, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ought to observe His worship to Him. He is Dhul Jalali wal Ikram subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most high, the most powerful. Look at our actions when it comes to the salah, with all its deficiencies and weaknesses. And He's the most forgiver subhanahu wa ta'ala. So He allowed us subhanahu wa ta'ala to worship Him and he permitted for us to ask for forgiveness after we finish the salah. Who taught us this? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The first words that comes when you make salam after the salah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam used to say that, seeking forgiveness from Allah, the last part of the night. وَالْمُسْتَغْفِرِينَ بِالْأَسْحَارِ, those who seek forgiveness from Allah at the time of as-sahar, right before fajr. مَدُّ الصَّلَاةَ بِاللَّيْلِ, as Al-Hasan al-Basri rahimahullah, he said, they extended the night with salah, and then they sit before fajr, they make istighfar like the sinners do. And the same thing, أَطْرَافُ النَّهَارِ, النهار, the beginning and the end of the day, seeking forgiveness from Allah. The salawatul al-khams. So the life of the believers is about istighfar and seeking forgiveness and repentance and changing their life on a daily basis. The night before is different than this day. The night to come is different than the day that we passed. As the hadith of the Prophet والسلام, and the ghafla, the forgetfulness, is when a person does not repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every day and every night. So to make it upon ourselves, did we repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala today? Repenting, fulfilling the conditions of it, to leave the sin, to have the determination not to commit it, and to regret of what happened, and to seek forgiveness from Allah. The night comes, repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, every day and every night. And this is one act of ubudiyyah to Allah, with the obligations, with the optional acts of worship, with being kind to others, not just during the day, not just in one aspect or the other, but continuity of the life of the believers till they return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعْبُدَ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. Worship your Lord till the moment of death befalls upon you. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك, ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك, ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا أبدا ما أبقيتنا, واجعله الوارث منا, واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا, وانصرنا على من عادانا, ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا, ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا, ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات, الأحياء منهم والأموات, إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعاء. اللهم أنج عبادك المستضعفين من المسلمين في كل مكان. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم, وأقم الصلاة.